hello and welcome to Amazing Mind, the Hypnosis TV talk show that introduces you to all sorts of interesting people and topics related to subconscious behavior. Today, I have an amazing guest. My first guest is Ted Moreno. Now, he is one of our newest instructors here at HMI College of Hypnotherapy. He also teaches your 101 class. Both of you are a distance student are here at the college in Tarzana, California. He's also an author of two of my favorite books. And today he is here on his book tour, talking about his newest book, 101 Tips for Creating Prosperity and Abundance for Professional Women. Please help me welcome my guest. Yeah. Well, Ted, if I'm not mistaken, you are a man.
Last time I checked, yes.
Excellent, good. And yet you wrote a book for creating abundance for professional women. Why write a book for women being a man?
Well, first, let me point out and give credit to my co-author, who is June Davidson, who is definitely a woman and has been around a long time and has done a lot of work with coaching and professional women and has been my mentor as well in many different ways. So I just wanted to give her credit.
Excellent.
I also want to add that as a hypnotherapist, the vast majority of my clients are women.
Really?
Yes.
Why do you think that is? Why do women come in for hypnotherapy more than men?
I think women are simply more open to discussing their problems or challenges or issues, and I think they're more open to seeking therapy of many different kinds.
I think you're right. So how do you help women, being a guy, create prosperity?
Well, first and foremost, I grew up with a mother who raised 8 kids, who was a wife who also worked as well. So I saw firsthand what it takes to be a working mom. And many of the clients that I have who are professional women have the same challenge even today. Okay.
What are some of the challenges that women have that are unique to women?
Well, I'll just give you one example. There was a study done by the Allianz Life Insurance Company of North America. They surveyed over 2,200 women from ages 25 to 75, all of them earning over $30,000 or more. And probably the most astounding thing that they discovered was even among the high-earning women, 49% of them were afraid of becoming bag ladies.
I hear that in my practice, mm-hmm. that women are afraid that somehow there'll be a catastrophe, a turn of events, and they will be destitute. But I've heard something else about women, and certainly in my practice and with my life experience, that women also are afraid that, well, they're imposters. Do you see that too?
Absolutely. So some people call it the fraud syndrome. So. Yes, I hear women tell me among all these, big brains, all these men, and I just feel like I don't belong in this group. When certainly, in my experience, they're some of the brightest humans that I've ever met, some of the most engaging and articulate people I've ever met. So you can plainly see that there's nothing, there is no element of fraud in these,
yes.
in these women.
What creates this feeling of either being destitute, being a fraud, or not feeling entitled or worthy of having abundance?
Well, I think if we look back over history, it's pretty obvious that throughout the history, women have been second-class citizens and have depended on men for their sustenance, for their financial abundance they may have. Certainly and thankfully that's beginning to change, but women of my mother's generation, the idea was that you would grow up, find a man to support you, and have kids. So for many women who are middle-aged, and certainly even the daughters of these women, that attitude is still very prevalent and in play at a subconscious level.
Do you want to know what's interesting? I was looking at some of the early psychology, and psychologists and psychiatrists used to believe that there was something terribly wrong with women if you didn't get your ego satisfied, if you didn't have your identity based on the success of your husband and your sons. And if that's not where you put your energy, you were mentally ill.
Mm-hmm.
And it took a woman, I believe her name was Betty Friedan, who was the first one who said maybe this isn't the way that we should look at female psychology. So we even have a history, even in this country, even in the mental health field. What are some of the limiting beliefs that women have?
There's many. I think one of the most predominant limiting beliefs that women have is that, you know, I'm not a man, therefore I can't make it in a man's world. And I hear that complaint every week from women coming in saying, and you know what, it's not a complaint. They're not complaining, they're just stating a fact when they say, it's hard to be a woman in a professional environment in a man's world.
Yes.
I remember in particular a very incredibly bright scientist working for JPL. Not only was she's a woman, she was a woman, but she's Indian. And so constantly being harassed and constantly being taken out of her hands. So I remember speaking with her and really getting a sense of frustration. But she just chalked it up to, you know, I made a choice to be in this field that is dominated by men, and I'm doing the best that I can.
Yeah. So. But you wrote 101 Tips for Creating Prosperity and Abundance. Can you teach us how we can use hypnotherapy to be able to change this very deep and very profound and very real programming?
Absolutely. The very first step is to identify the programming. So to be really clear, if you have that idea of, you know, women can't make it in a men's world, and you got that message maybe from an early age, to be very clear that that's still in play, or, you know, the idea that you're a fraud, the very first step is to identify the patterns of thinking that are holding you back from being a successful professional woman. And this may take some work, and certainly the, you know, a hypnotherapist like myself can help identify those patterns of thinking and behavior.
What's next?
The next step would be to identify how you want it to be, a compelling outcome, a goal. Okay, so if I don't want to feel like a fraud, how do I want to feel? How do I want to project myself into the professional world? How do I need to change my behavior so that I get more respect? A lot of times, you know, there's a lot of courage required to stand up and to assert oneself in the face of maybe professional harassment or discrimination.
Absolutely.
So we want to get very clear about what the compelling outcome is going to be. It might be a level of income, it might be a level of stature, or a level in the company or organization. It's very important that women get clear about where they want to be.
You know, does everyone need to see a hypnotherapist to overcome this? Why a book then if we need to see a hypnotherapist?
Well, these are tips, okay? So what they do is they just, I think, are reminders of the things that we want to think about on a daily basis. I think hypnotherapy can be very effective in the short term or the long term. It's not the only modality that will be helpful, but certainly in my view, it's one of the most powerful.
Can you take us through an exercise, if we don't want to come see a hypnotherapist, some other ways of accessing the subconscious mind, using some other ways to penetrate the basic programming and change the outcome? Can you take us through?
Absolutely. It's very simple. So we'll do a short little exercise, shall
we? Can we do it for everybody here in the studio audience and everybody watching at home?
Yes,
what
absolutely.
Do we need?
Okay, so the first thing we want to do is just close our eyes. And we want to draw all our attention into the breathing. And the reason for that is because the breathing is what's happening now. We want to give ourselves an opportunity to disengage from everything out there and allow ourselves to focus on the inner work. Allow the breath to guide you into a very calm and comfortable state. Notice the breathing, notice the feeling of the physical body, and as much as possible, allow your attention to be in the physical body here now. Every breath allowing you to become more calm, more comfortable, and much more relaxed. Now shift the attention from the breath into some goal or outcome or something that you want to attain. It may be a level of income, it may be something that you want to do or accomplish, it may be a position of influence. Take a couple of minutes to allow that to become very clear to you. Even if you're not entirely certain, allow your subconscious mind to move in the direction that it needs to or that it wants to. And you may even get some information or revelations as you allow your subconscious mind to explore what that would look like. a compelling outcome, a desired goal, a state of being. It may be something like courage or strength. Again, it may be an annual income. It may be a very busy professional life with fun and all the wonderful benefits of a high level of income. Most importantly now, allow yourself to feel what that would feel like as if you had it now. The sense of accomplishment, the sense of pride, the feeling of security, power. All the while being very relaxed and comfortable. The idea here is to allow your mind and your body to get very comfortable with this compelling outcome. Remember that the subconscious mind likes what is known and does not like what is unknown. So we want to get the subconscious mind and our conscious mind as well familiar with what we want, more familiar and more comfortable than how it is now. And when we do that enough, when we practice this on a daily basis, our subconscious mind begins to create opportunities, begins to present us with ideas, and allows us to have the behaviors that will move us in the direction of our goal. Really allow yourself to feel what it would feel like if you had what you want now. Imagine what it would look like, sound like, maybe even taste like or smell like. Really allow yourself to feel that physically now. And you might even give yourself the affirmation, so shall it be, or this is coming to me now. And then we can finish up by acknowledging the abundance that you have in your life now. Really get that you are one of the wealthiest people in the world right here, right now. If you're sitting in an air-conditioned television studio, then you are already in abundance. Really allow yourself to connect with that now. Draw your attention back into your physical body. Give yourself a little commitment that you're going to do this on a daily basis. And then open your eyes and you can come to a fully alert and awake state.
Ted, that was wonderful. And I pictured this show, Amazing Mind, going out to 10 million people all over the world. And that was my visualization. Because I remember you told me, Lisa, when you do this, make sure that your goal is realistic.
That's right.
So I chose that realistic goal.
That's tip number 62, set realistic goals.
It's right there. You know, Ted, everybody is going to want a copy of your book, 100 Tips for Creating Prosperity and Abundance for Professional Women. Where can we get this?
You can go to my website at tedmoreno.com, or you can find my book at amazon.com. But I'll make our viewers and listeners a deal that if they contact me through tedmoreno.com, they can purchase my book, and I'll give them a free half-hour to hour coaching session.
Wow!
On the topic of prosperity and abundance.
That is a wonderful offer. I hope everybody takes advantage of that.
I hope so, too.
And you're open for private practice. Do you also Skype and FaceTime all over the world?
I do, yes.
And where's your private practice?
I have two locations. I see clients in South Pasadena as well as Covina.
And you can reach Ted Moreno at hmigrads.com. You can also find him at hypnosis.edu on the instructors page. I hope you see him when you come to HMI College, or if you're a distance student. And you know what? I want to give you the last word. Can you read us one of your favorite tips or one of your favorite quotes?
Yeah, every quote in here is by a woman. Okay, I think there may be two quotes by me, but I'm the author, right? So this is a quote by Maya Angelou. We've all heard about Maya Angelou, right?
Yes.
And so she says, "You may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats, so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, and how you can still come out of it." So I'll leave you with that.
Thank you so much. I want to thank my guest, Ted Moreno.
And my pleasure.
And I want to let you all know that we're going to take a short break, but when we come back, we're going to meet another HMI, this time a distance grad, and we're going to learn how to turn thoughts into manifestations. Stay tuned. We'll be right back on HypnosisTV.com. Right.